What's up, bud? It's Rob. This is Apparel Success, and through building my own clothing brand to over six figures in sales, I want to talk to you about how to grow your clothing brand from scratch. And in this video here, I'm really going to bring you back to that starting point, and I'm going to cover how exactly to get momentum for your clothing brand and to build brand value from the very beginning when you don't have anything to leverage, okay? That's what the topic of this video is going to be. I think it's one of the most important topics to cover for a new clothing brand, and I think it's really going to help you when it comes to getting the ball rolling for your clothing brand and gaining momentum. This channel here is sponsored by my buds over at Design Crowd, and if you need designs made for your clothing brand, I seriously recommend that you check them out. I use them myself. They're a website that allows you to crowdsource designs from designers located all around the world, and for a special $100 VIP offer for Apparel Success viewers only, head over to designcrowd.com/apparel to learn more, or simply use the discount code APPARREL when you post a project on Design Crowd. Okay, so I'm going to start out this video by talking about the difference between investing sweat equity and financial equity into your clothing brand. And the reason why I want to do this is because you need one or the other in order to grow a clothing brand and to drive your clothing brand forward. There's no reality where the idea of your clothing brand is going to drive your clothing brand forward alone. You either need to invest sweat equity, and sweat equity is essentially your own labor, your own time, your own efforts into growing your clothing brand, or you need to invest financial equity. And this is where you have a large sum of cash that you can pile into your clothing brand to market your clothing brand and get the word out about your clothing brand and move things forward that way. 99.999% of everybody watching this video, including you, doesn't have the financial equity to invest in your clothing brand. And what this means is that you're gonna have to invest your own sweat equity in growing your company. And this means that you're gonna have to work really hard, you're gonna have to put in your own effort, sacrifice your own time in order to grow your clothing brand from the very beginning. And the best analogy for this is building a fire. So if you were to think about going into the woods to start a fire, it can take literally hours of your time, full days, collecting wood and rubbing the wood together to try and get that spark going, right? And once you get that spark going, then all you have to do is just throw some leaves on it, throw some sticks on it, and it keeps the thing going. And it's much easier at that point to get the whole thing to grow into this gigantic forest fire that is really just raging and taking the whole woods by storm. And essentially, that's what you want to be doing with your clothing brand, is getting this spark going for your clothing brand by investing your own sweat equity into your clothing brand by the efforts that you're putting in and the strategies that you're using without investing a lot of money. This is exactly how I grew my own clothing brand from scratch. And when I say from scratch, I mean I had absolutely nothing going for me. I had zero to leverage. I had no celebrity friends to ask to wear my clothing. It was just starting from scratch, just like how you're starting right now. And the way that we grew was through learning the necessary skills to reach out to these celebrities in a way that they'd want to respond, and it was a win-win situation. And by rubbing those sticks together like you're trying to start a fire over and over again until you get some results and you're able to build brand value. And there's something known as the Pareto principle, which is basically, as good things happen to you, the probability that more good things are going to happen to you increases. And this is essentially what building momentum is for your clothing brand. When you get some wins for your clothing brand, when you get your first amount of customers, if you land a celebrity or two celebrities, it becomes way easier to get more celebrities involved and to gain more customers, because now the whole perception of your clothing brand has changed. It's completely different now. The way that everybody's coming across your clothing brand, the way that everybody's viewing it, is now in a completely different light. And this new light that you've been able to attain for your clothing brand is really going to allow you to gain the momentum to keep going up and to keep getting better and better and better results for your clothing brand. The problem with this is that most people stay stuck down here trying to start a fire forever, and they never even get that spark going for their clothing brand. In order to be one of the few clothing brands that actually gets that spark to happen, where you have customers coming in and you can then leverage those customers to take your clothing brand to even bigger and better places, you have to be able to work hard enough, smart enough, and over a long enough amount of time to actually see those results come back to you. It's kind of like you're pushing this boulder up a mountain and you're just constantly like trying to get to the top of the mountain. You're just trying to get to the top of the mountain. And then finally, once you get those customers, once you get a celebrity wearing your clothing, the ball starts to go down the hill and you're basically just steering everything as it's going, as you have that momentum. And once you have that momentum, it just becomes so much easier to make sales, to get new customers, and to really take your clothing brand to the next level. The hardest part about running a clothing brand is right at the beginning, likely where you're at right now, where you don't have anything, you don't have anything to leverage, you don't have any customers, you don't really have any celebrities and influencers yet. That's the hardest part about running a clothing brand. Once you have those things, once you're able to attain those things from scratch, it becomes a lot easier to get your next customer and to get your next celebrity and influencer endorsement. So what I really recommend that you do is take an honest look at your clothing brand and ask yourself, is my clothing brand truly connecting deeply enough with the audience that I'm trying to sell to? Because a lot of clothing brand owners have a blind spot here where they think that their clothing brand is already good and they wonder, why exactly am I not selling to anybody? But usually it's because their brand concept is just simply not aligned enough with the people that they're trying to sell to. And if you make a simple tweak there, all of a sudden people are relating to it, you get your customers coming in, and you can get this ball rolling. Another thing that I want you to do is really be strategic and efficient when it comes to reaching out to celebrities and trying to get your clothing onto celebrities and influencers. Because if you do this in an efficient way, and if you're strategic about it, where you're making it a win-win situation for you and the celebrity, you're not asking for anything in return, you're just giving them free clothing, then it makes it a lot easier for you to land those celebrity and influencer endorsements and to get the ball rolling for your clothing brand. And the last thing that I want to say here is that you need to be able to do this for a long enough amount of time. It's not going to be perfect. There's no way where all of this is just going to be perfect for you. You're just going to have to put in that effort, constantly learn, and just constantly grind it out until you're able to attain that brand value that you need to really take your brand to bigger and better places. Check out my clothing brand marketing masterclass. It's 100% free to watch. All you have to do to get access is go to apparelsuccess.com/masterclass. You can watch the whole thing for free. And if you've made it to this point in the video, I want to tell you about the closed Facebook group that we have for Apparel Success. There's a link in the description below. Follow that link. Join us in the group. See you in the next one. Peace.